Olivet Boys and Girls Club Notes on BCTV is supported by the Olivet Boys and Girls Club.
Hello and welcome to Club Notes, a monthly TV show of the Olivet Boys and Girls Clubs. This is our September show. The kids are back at school, the clubs are starting back up, and there's a lot of activities that are going on at the Olivet Boys and Girls Club. We're going to be talking with one of our staff members who also was a club kid that came up through the club and is now working with us. We'll be talking with Ryan Hightower, who is our unit director at the PAL Club at 325 Walnut Street. But before we get started, we'd like to put up our contact information in case you're interested in getting in touch with the Olivet Boys and Girls Club. We're located throughout the city of Reading, and you can find out our addresses on our website. Our administrative offices are located at 1161 Pershing Boulevard. It's Reading, PA 19611. Give us a call, 610-373-1314. You can visit our website at www.olivetbgc.org. We're on Facebook, Twitter, and all social media platforms. So it's a great time of year. This is the 121st year that the Olivet Boys and Girls Clubs has been operating. And what we would like to do before we get started, we'd like to show a copy of our newsletter. And if you are interested in getting on our mailing list, you can give us a call and we can put you on the mailing list. This issue which just came out talks about our summer programs, talks about our RBI baseball, talking about a very big surprise that Ryan was involved with a couple of weeks ago. Updates are Leaders and Legends Dinner, some golf information, fundraisers, and importantly, introduces you to our new CEO, Christopher Winters, who has been with us since the start of June. So this gives you a snapshot of what's been going on at the Olivet Boys and Girls Club. And we just wanted you to know that, how can you help? We're always looking for volunteers. Looking for people to help spread the word about the Olivet Boys and Girls Club. As I mentioned, Ryan's an alumni of the club. If you're an alumni of the club and would like to reconnect, get in touch with us. And we're always looking for donations, time, talent, resources. It's a great organization to support. I'm proud to say that I haven't been around for all 121 years, but I've been around for 30 of them. So it's a great time, and it's always exciting for September. But this is my guy, Ryan Hightower. I'm pleased to say I saw him grow up as a young club member, and now he's a fine young man. Ryan, welcome aboard.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
So, Ryan, I could tell all kinds of stories about you. What growing up at the club, what did it mean to you, and what led you to become a club director?
Well, I am the club director at the PAL unit, but my original home club was Clinton Street. I started there at 6. I remember my brother, which is 3 years older than me, he got in the club first, and we went to sign him up, and I was 5 at the time. So, I was burnt up. I was upset. Because I wanted to be a part of something. I seen something special within the club. So I wanted to be a part of that. So once I turned 6, there was no holding me back. I was all over the gym. The first place I was in the gym is where I learned to play basketball at, learned to shoot. Steve Rosanoli, a lot of guys helped me along the way to actually had a decent career up at Reading High. That's pretty much where I started.
Okay. And I do say that Ryan is one of the club kids that I did follow at Reading High a little bit more. His dad was always big involved with you, and you had a great support system. What led you to getting a job at the Olivet Boys and Girls Club? How did you reconnect with us?
Well, I worked in the club in 2007 as a teen center coordinator. So that's when I first met Christine Barlett, who was the original club director there. I just felt an emptiness inside. I wanted to reconnect with the kids of the community. I did a bunch of jobs. I worked at the Children's Home of Reading for 6 years, Prospectus Burkles for 3 years. So I just had gained a lot of knowledge and experience, and I wanted to bring it back home and apply it to working with the kids in our community. And I came back, and Christine was still around, and we interviewed, and she told me from the gate when I interviewed, she said, "You're going to be the club director here." And that was a lot of pressure put on me at the time, But I understood that, and slowly she groomed me to you know, take over the reins. And once I got back in the club, I realized that I was at home where I needed to be.
That's it. That's it. You know, and I told you last summer after your first summer that I was proud of you. I pulled you aside at the pool, and we had that tender moment, and I meant it. What'd you guys do with this summer? What was the summer like?
Summer camp. This is the first time that I actually ran the whole summer camp, and it was very challenging. I'm not going to lie. Different activities every Tuesday. We went to Blue Mountain Camp, which is up in Hamburg. Just different activities, archery up there, different rotations. So that was fun and a good experience for the kids. Every Friday, we would go to Clinton Street Pool and be at the pool all day. And throughout the week, we had different activities planned, IMAX movies. We would walk to the playground, 3rd and Spruce, and do different activities just to keep the kids engaged and involved the whole summer.
Okay. Now, you know, we mentioned the PAL unit, PAL Club, is located at 325 Walnut Street. The building is 112 years old.
It's as old as you.
We'll talk about that. No, but, you know, the PAL Club was the armory. It's like an armory that you see up and down the East Coast, and it's an impressive castle-like looking building. So as you're driving up Walnut Street and you start to go up the hill, that's the PAL on the left-hand side. What are your hours, and what are some of the activities that you're starting as you start the school year program?
Our hours are 10 to 7, and some of the activities that we have going on is Project Learn, what we call our homework time. Kids come in, they eat snack right away, they break down into different age groups, and then they go into their rooms, and we'll start homework time for the first 45 minutes. And then we rotate into different groups. Today we had chess club come in. Just different activities that we do throughout the day. We have a tech lab where we have different computer activities for the kids to participate in. And then we have across the street, which is a bonus, the CFA, which they have different activities, guitar lessons, piano, different things. So we kind of go back and forth. So the kids are pretty active during the evening.
And what's our age groups that we're serving?
6 to 18.
Okay. So it's 6 to 18, boys and girls. How does a young person get to be a member? What do they have to do?
Just come through the doors. We're working on our system right now. I know online we had to sign up online, but that's down right now. But just walk through the doors. Our address, 325 Walnut Street. We have the application there. You fill it out.
And what does it cost to be a member?
$15 for the whole year.
$15 for the year?
Yes, $15.
I don't remember back in the old day, $5. Yes. $5. You know, so we really have kind of kept it affordable, and I think that's what it's all about, is that it's recreation. You come in and you play in a historic gym at the PAL. That's there used to be professional wrestling, boxing, all kinds of basketball was run there. And you have some games rooms. What do you have? Some pool tables?
Yeah, pool table, rec room, ping pong table. We have a team center with an Xbox system that we play. We often have tournaments there. Just different activities to keep the kids busy.
Now, also, you have Kids Cafe going on.
Yes.
And so what's that?
That's our after-school feeding program. We serve dinner between 5 and 6 o'clock every evening. That's through Reading Rec. They provide meals for our kids in the evening. So each rotation we have about 15 minutes for the guys to eat.
So you can come right from school, get some homework help, mm-hmm. blow off some steam,
yep.
play with your friends, eat dinner.
Yep.
Eat dinner and have all of these opportunities. And like we said, it's recreation, it's education, and it's guidance. So, you know, that's the important thing, talking to the kids about making good decisions and things like that. So you also have the Dream and Map program helps out in your program. And how's that been working out?
It's been going very well. We hired a new supervisor and an assistant to revamp the program. And as far as we know, it's going good. Everything is up to par right now.
Now, we do have one of our upcoming programs is going to be our flag football program, which will be kicking off in October. And Bernie Nowotarski, who's well-known throughout the local football community, is going to be our football commissioner coordinator, and so we're looking forward to a great opportunity with that. Now we teased a little bit about this big announcement. When they said that you were going to be getting a big award from Boys and Girls Clubs of America, what did that mean to you?
It meant a lot. I mean, that honestly was a complete surprise, and just the fact that I can be a part of something, giving back such a large part to the community and something that I grew up in, it just really, you know, tugged at my heart, and I was glad to be a part of that.
We should mention, and it was in the paper, but Lowe's and Boys and Girls Clubs of America selected the PAL Club to be win $100,000. And it was a program called Flip My Club. And, you know, as you got a 112-year-old building, it's starting to show its age. It had been renovated a couple of times. But as we all get older, you know, things start to break down in the infrastructure. So we were looking at some roofing, some other cosmetic works internally. And I know that Ryan's been sitting in on some meetings. So he's given some ownership. And it's really kind of neat that, you know, you get to... you know, have a say-so in it. Now, who was the celebrity that showed up and helped out that day?
Andre Reed.
The one day a Buffalo Bill shows up and I didn't make it. No, but that was good. That was good. Andre Reed is a member of the Boys and Girls Clubs of America Hall of Fame, an alumni of the Allentown Club. He went to the 6th Street Club in Allentown and came back. And that's where Bernie really kind of connected with the club and Christopher Winters. And so we're going to keep you abreast of what's going on. Hopefully we'll get the renovations done, you know, before the weather, you know, things are kind of up in the air right now, but we'll keep you abreast. And your staff was very surprised, and I know you got very surprised about it. And that's a good feeling. It's a good feeling. Good feeling. So let's just, we're going to move along a little bit and talk about our program going on, and I just want to show a picture of our staff. This is not all of our Olivet staff, but a couple of key members of our staff that did a great job in terms of getting the clubs ready throughout the month, the end of August, beginning of September. And all of our clubs are up and running. We've got our satellite sites in Robinsonia, West Reading, Holy Spirit. We're operational in Glenside. You know, we're all of our clubs in the city, Pandora, Mulberry, Pal, Oakbrook, and Clinton Street. When I started with the club, we only had two clubs. Now it's hard to remember. I didn't even have to have a cheat sheet on this. But here's our key staff, and I'm not going to name everybody, but this is the core group that keeps us going. There's a lot of experience there, a lot of energy. And the big guy in the back, Ryan, always in the back. But no, we appreciate everything that they did to get the clubs ready, and they had a great summer program. We can't get our clubs ready without the help of some of our friends. And earlier this month was the Day of Caring from United Way. And we have several of our photos from the Day of Caring we can show that took place in terms of renovating the clubs. This is the t-shirt. We always do the back t-shirt shot. It's an easy shot. Oh, let's go forward. This is over at our Mulberry Street Club, and Mulberry Street Club is actually even older than the PAL Club. So we've got a couple of properties that are should be on the historic registry. They were doing some painting. We had employees from Alcon, M&T Bank, and Cambridge and Lee. This is in the gym. They were touching up, doing some of the paint. And over on Mulberry Street, we had renovated the club and put the new gym in the mid-90s. So it's starting to need a little love. Then they were doing some painting and cosmetic work throughout the buildings. So it was a great opportunity for United Way volunteers to come in and... You know, we're not the greatest of painters, you know. I know. You know, but in one day they did more painting, and we greatly appreciated the United Way Day of Caring. So that was just to give you a taste of what went on those days. And I should mention Alcon, M&T Bank, and Cambridge and Lee. We did have a group that did show up earlier, before the United Way Day of Caring, from RKL. And they helped out and did a little bit of work over at Ryan's home club, over at the Clinton Street Club. Did you do ceramics when you were a kid?
Yes, I did.
This is the old ceramic studio. And you had Miss D and Mary Ann.
Miss D,
yeah. Every kid over at Clinton Street, they did ceramics, and they never let an ugly piece go out. They'd do a little touch-up and a little finish, and when Mom or Dad got that gift, it was top shelf. But they were doing some cleanup over there, and then afterwards, they were down in the gym, and as you can see, a couple years ago, we did some mascots, and we've still got the posters around. You saw the Lightning Wolves at Mulberry Street, Cobra Squad over at Clinton Street. So we kind of still have those hanging around in the old shirts and stuff, and so it kind of just keeps us connected with what's going on before. And Ryan, you played a lot of basketball in there, so that's it. So no, we appreciate all of our volunteers that came out and helped out with the United Way Day of Caring, as well as helping out with some of the cleanups at the club. Like I said, we wrapped up August 9th, and we reopened mid-September. Yeah. So, you know, it was very hectic in terms of getting the clubs ready. I do want to recognize our AmeriCorps program, which is a group of 17 to 24-year-olds that they help us out and assist with the club. You talked about the Kids Lit program. What did that entail?
That's our reading program that we do. We usually do that twice a week for an hour a day. Just different reading programs, going over different books. Just different activities that we do to keep the kids engaged, helping out with their reading fundamentals.
Okay. And they also do some artwork with them, just develop relationships and help out with the educational component. Now, to be an AmeriCorps, you must verification of United States citizenship, must have a high school diploma, GED, or a commitment to achieving one. Background checks required, must be available to work Monday through Friday, 3 o'clock to 6 o'clock. There's an educational stipend. You get a living stipend. So if you are interested and you're between 17 and 24, looking for an opportunity, maybe you're looking for direction, this may be something that you may want to get involved with. So Kat Royer, you can give her a call, 610-373-1314. Here's some of the students that were working with the group over at Clinton Street. Anae in the middle, along with some of her coworkers, working with the kids in the multipurpose room at Clinton Street. This is a group photo of all of the summer AmeriCorps students. And did you just get your summer students just started back up?
No, they start back the beginning of October.
Oh, okay, beginning of October. So there's a little bit of time if you are interested and in getting involved. But here's some of our staff: Chris Winters, Candy Ninfo, as well as Kat and Abby, and I see Rose in the front. And I don't want to name them all because I'll miss them. But AmeriCorps is a great opportunity if you're a young person between the ages of 17 and 24 looking for an employment opportunity, possible career move. This would be a great opportunity to get involved with. So please give Kat a call, 610-373-1314, and she'd love to talk to you about it. Moving along, we had a donation. There was a family, the Owens family, and they developed a board game which involves creativity and drawing, and it's a very hands-on, and they've been marketing the game on Amazon, and it's Adam and Megan Owens, and I believe Adam's in the picture here with some of our students over at Oakbrook, and they were doing some drawings, and they've donated a copy of the starting line game, and our kids have already been very excited about it at Oakbrook, and we look forward to expanding it over to PAL and the rest of the clubs. But we thank the Owens family for supporting the club, and we wish them well in their entrepreneurial adventures in terms of creating a game. I know we tried to do some board games years ago, and it's kind of tough to get hit on all cylinders. So best wishes to the Owens family. One of the other programs that Boys and Girls Clubs of America is really going to be pushing this fall is a program called Take a Stand for Drug-Free Land. We've talked about it at staff level. We've talked about it, within the communities. But there is a drug epidemic throughout the community. We really want to get the message out about taking a stand and just educating our students. And that's, if they know what the pitfalls are, it makes they'll make better decisions. How do you feel about that?
Yeah, I think it's crucial to implement that with our kids, especially nowadays in the community. We all know, I've lived here in Reading for 35 years, so I understand the streets and what can go on sometimes. So to let these kids know in an appropriate manner at an early age, I think is beneficial to them to understand that you do have choices. You don't have to go along with everything that your friends may be doing or somebody in your family may be doing or involved in. You have a choice, and you have a choice to make a better life for yourself. So I think this is great.
Yeah, we talk about it. Recreation, obviously, that's the easy thing. The education, but it's the guidance. It's about making the right decisions. It's about, getting involved with drugs, alcohol, getting involved with negative behavior. Ryan, like you said, he grew up on Clinton Street or Greenwich Street, just around the corner. Mm-hmm. Not the easiest of places to grow up, and he came out of it, but there's others that we could go back and forth about, the ones that, we lost or, that aren't in a positive light at the time. So we do want to really, we'll talk about the Take a Stand for Drug-Free Land. Quickly, we're going to go through our golf tournament. A couple weeks ago, we had the Blue Mountain Camp golf tournament. That's a beautiful picture. I just had to show it. That was out at the tee. I believe it's number 15 at the Berkshire. They were having some contest holes, but we want to thank Jamie Mack and his wife who helped to chair cocktail party golf tournament. It was our most successful to date. They had great post golf activities. I didn't make it. This was the first year I didn't play. And so I'm just disappointed when I look at these pictures. But this was a party afterwards where they had some live auctions. They had great food. And this is all to benefit the Blue Mountain Camp. And then Ryan and I spent a great deal of time up at camp this summer. Oh, yeah. And we do want to welcome on board Mark Coghlan, who is our new camp director. He just started on with the club several weeks ago. World Electronics has been a big supporter. The Rado family, Mike Duddy, they have been involved with us almost since day one. And they were given some recognition. And we always appreciate our friends at World Electronics. This is Jamie Mack with Brad White Sr., and I know Brad White Sr. is watching right now because after every show, he calls me and tells me what I did right and did wrong. So we wanted to make sure that Brad got on TV tonight. This was a picture of the lodge at the camp, and Brad and his family have been a godsend to the Blue Mountain Camp, and their support and energy has really benefited the kids of the PAL and the rest of the Olivet organization. One of our staff members yesterday received an award, and we're going to share that with you now. I don't even know if you know this, but Rose Morales received the Unsung Hero Award at the Karen Awards breakfast, and this is Rose getting her star. And Rose has been with us for 20 years, and in terms of behind the scenes on everything that gets done, there's very little that Rose doesn't have some sort of connection with. And so it was a real pleasure, and I had received the Unsung Hero Award before, so I know what it means for her. This is Rose with her award, and she was looking for a place to put it in her office, and I snuck a view at it today. So congratulations, Rose. And some of her co-workers went along. We've got Christopher Winters, we've got Rose, Lori Waxler, and Candy Ninfo. And Candy also won the award a couple years ago. So it was great that she went out and supported Rose. And it was a great, great, well-deserved award for Rose. I didn't even tell her I was going to do this tonight. So we're wrapping up the show. If you are interested in becoming a member of the Boys and Girls Clubs, go to the website, look for one of the locations near us, stop by. If you're over near the PAL, stop by, go in and say, I'd like to meet Mr. Hightower. He'll come out and talk to you about it. It's $15 for the year, or go to any of the clubs. You just stop in. You know, you can see Candy up at Pandora, Rob over at Oakbrook, Jackie at Mulberry. That's where I get in trouble, starting to name people, and Deja at Clinton Street, as well as all of our satellites. So I can honestly say there's a place near you. We just want to remind you that we've got some upcoming programs. If you are interested in flag football, that's going to be coming up soon. We'll have Bernie on our next show, and we'll talk a little bit about the flag football programs. There's every day after school, recreation, education, and guidance. Any last words, Ryan?
Oh, thank you for having me up here and giving me an opportunity to represent PAL.
Hey, you know, the guy changed his phone number last week. I thought he didn't love me anymore. I thought he didn't love me.
Never so that.
I tracked him down. I know. It's Olivet Love. Olivet Love. But no, I just, you know, like I said, you know, I pulled him aside last year, and I just said that, you know, I was proud of him because, you know, I know where he came from, you know, his support system, and what he's doing at the PAL Club. And, you know, it's a good thing. It's a good thing. And that's what we're looking at. We like to develop from within, you know, so there's a lot of opportunities. He was a gym rat, you know, came to the club every day, and look where it got him. So for Ryan and myself, we'll see you next month. Stop and visit one of the clubs. Take care.
Olivet Boys and Girls Club Notes on BCTV is supported by the Olivet Boys and Girls Club.